is the group with all those household names we recognise, like Labs and Cockers and Goldies. This is Romeo the Labrador, who won Best of Breed. He's 3.5 years old, and he's here all the way from Italy, and his handler says they're very, very tired, but extremely happy to be here.
So here we go with the gundog group, dogs that were originally trained to find live game or to retrieve game. And the judge for this is Mrs. Zena Thorne Andrews. Let's join Frank Kane and Jessica Holm.
And another massive entry, and this one, Loch Romeo, has come all the way from Italy to compete. Belongs to Franco Barberi, who also bred him and handles him in the ring tonight.
Now, this is not the first time that Franco's come from Italy to take Best of Breed at Crufts. He's a wonderful breeder from the north of Italy. Very successful. His Labrador's all of beautiful type and beautiful temperament, yes.
I want to play, Dad. A big round of applause for one of the most popular breeds in the group, a solid workman of a dog.
Riding at that thick otter tail, double coated, big substance in the body.
So we've seen all 32 breeds in the gundog group. You will have your own personal favourites, but now it's down to the group judge, Mrs. Zena Thorne Andrews, to make her shortlist selection.
She's come to the end of the line. Who's she going to pull? She's pulling the Weimarana and the Spanish Water Dog.
The Irish Water Spaniel, last year's winner, comes out again. The American Cocker's coming out, and the Labrador. Great cheer for him. The Chesapeake Bay. I thought Zena would like that one. So functional.
And she's taken the... Is it the Wirehead Vizsla? She's taken the Wirehead Vizsla.
The German Wirehead Pointer and the German Shorthead Pointer. And the Braco Italiano.
The boards are coming out into the ring. Zena doesn't normally waste much time. Who is she going to take for the Gundog Group winner for 2013? It's the Italian Labrador, the Labrador Retriever. Italian champion Loch Romeo takes the group.
Wonderful dog, he's a beautiful Labrador. And Franco, he'll be delighted with that. He speaks very little English, but I'm sure he's very happy.
The Weimarana comes into group two, show champion Gunnelt Dice at Stride View. The beautiful German Shorthead Pointer. Show champion and Dutch champion Cavacani top at the top into group three. And the Irish Water Spaniel won the group last year, has to be content with group four this year, but I'm sure they'll be chuffed to bits.
So victory in the Gundog group, the largest entry of all in terms of breeds, the Labrador Retriever. It's Romeo, who's come over from Italy. Let's get a reaction from his owner breeder handler. It's the same person who is with Sonali. We will hear from them straight after this break.
Franco, congratulations. You must Thank be you so, much. So pleased. How are you feeling?
Sorry, very tired. Very long travel and very long, but he's very happy. Many, many happy.
Yeah, you look very happy. We can see it in your face. Yes. Franco and 3.5-year-old Romeo here travelled all the way from Italy last night. And can I just say, they beat almost 500 other labs to be here and a total of almost 5,000 dogs to get to this position.
Incredible. It's not possible. Incredible.
Incredible.
Incredible, yes.
How will you now prepare for Sunday's Best in Show?
Oh, sleep. Many sleep.
You just need...
A good night's sleep, I think, was the answer to that before tomorrow's Best in Show. So the Labrador Retriever takes the Gundog group. Labrador owners all over the country will be cheering, and that's our first international winner this year at Crufts. Peter Purvis and Jessica Holm with me in the studio now. Jessica, we've had a lot of tweets about the Labrador, and I do have to put this point to you. He's quite chunky.
Solid.
Solid.
Solid, well-made. Yes, he's a big dog. They're supposed to be a big dog with that lashing otter tail, a solid animal, but you saw how sound he was on the move. You know, you've got a big frame there, but carried effortlessly, and a worthy group winner. Now-
Welcome back to Crufts 2013. We are here live at the NEC in Birmingham, and very shortly the seven finalists will come into this arena to compete for the title Best in Show. Let's just remind ourselves of the full lineup. The winner of the Terrier group is called Lampard. He's a Skye Terrier. From the Hound group, we have the Petit Basset Griffon Bondine Gilly. She was reserved Best in Show a couple of years ago. Gabby is the gorgeous Tibetan Terrier. She won the Utility Group. That's Theo, the King Charles Spaniel. He won the Toy Group. And there is the Labrador Retriever, Lochmore Romeo, all the way from Italy, who won the Gundog Group. Then today, added to that list from the Working Group, we had the Bernese Mountain Dog Breeze. She's very beautiful. And finally, the Pastoral Group, the Australian Shepherd Dog, who is called Tiffany. So from that list of seven, there are a few who would be first-time winners for their breed. It's going to be a very exciting evening. And
over the last 4 days, the Kennel Club has been celebrating happy, healthy dogs from a vast entry of over 25,000 dogs here at Crufts, which still remains, after over 120 years, the world's greatest dog show. We are delighted to welcome the chairman of the Kennel Club, Professor Steve Dean, who is escorting our Best in Show judge for Crufts 2013, Mr. Jeff Corrish. Judged here on Thursday night, the winner of the Terrier group, the Skye Terrier.
Skye Terrier, of course, is called Lampard. It's his pet name, of course. He's a three-year-old dog.
Also champion Selena, the special one. Thursday night, the winner of the Hound Group.
And delighted to see this beautiful little Petit Basset Griffon Vendien, the winner of the Hound Group, champion Soul Trader Peekaboo, entering the Best in Show ring.
Judged on Friday night, the winner of the Utility Group, the Tibetan Terrier.
From Mould in Flintshire, David Roberts, Judy Price and Fiona Whitehead own this lovely 18-month-old bitch, Gabby, Kaibo Pandorama.
Of the toy group, the King Charles Spaniel.
The delightful little Charlie champion, maybe Theo. Handled by Tanya Ireland. Owned by William Moffat and Joyce Robbins. Not remotely fazed by the Best in Show ring as she takes her place as winner of the toy group.
It really was Super Saturday here yesterday. The winner from the largest group of them all, the Gundog group, the Labrador Retriever.
As you hear, a very popular winner. This is Romeo, this dog 3.5 years old. Comes from Cesara in Italy. The handler is the ring, Franco Barberi, breed, bred and owners.
And as we have seen tonight, the penultimate of our group winners from the world group, the Bernese Mountain Dog.
A wonderful win for Bernese Mare and Carol Hartley Mare. Champion Meadow Park, Whispers Breeze, winning the working group. They won the Breeders' Stakes as well. A tremendous Crufts for them.
Another hugely popular winner here with Angie Allen. This, of course, champion Allmark Fifth Avenue Junior Warrant.
And our very, very grateful thanks indeed to our seven group judges. Thank you very, very much.
And a huge round of applause for the Labrador Retriever. Coming into the ring now, this is Romeo. This Italian dog. Franco Barberi there handling. And Jeff going to give this a good look over. Come from Cesara in Italy. First title in England. First time in England, in fact, so first title as well. Franco's actually been showing dogs for 18 years. This will be probably the biggest moment in his dog showing life. This is an Italian champion, Lochmar Romeo.
Franco, very famous as a Labrador breeder from Italy. And I'm glad to see that this dog's got his composure. He came in a little bit unsettled. He took a dislike to some of the cameras the other night, but he's got his act together now. A beautiful Labrador, beautifully balanced, that thick otter tail and dense coat, and a beautiful, kind expression.
Just confirming the entry here, over 5,000 gun dogs were here. That was the best. Now then, what are we going to do? Jeff, oh, he's called for the boards, has he? Yes, he has. Wonderful team of helpers here at Crufts, all volunteers. The boards they're bringing out, and here come the trophies for Best in Show. This is such a moment, the world's greatest dog show without exception. The biggest, the best, the trophy, the most coveted, probably in the dog world.
Just looking at heads and expression now as he goes down the line.
Seven handlers all having palpitations, waiting to see who's going to be selected to win Crufts Best in Show 2013.
And the nice thing is Jeff doesn't have to rush it. He can take his time, he can change his opinion, he can do everything until he indicates we don't know where he's going to go. And he's taking a really good look, isn't he?
He looks very relaxed though, big smile on his face.
Well, he's judged a lot of big competitions, but this is the biggest, so he's experienced.
Last few seconds before he makes his decision. My word.
Yes, oh, I'm thrilled to bits. And Gilly, champion sole trader, Peekaboo, the Petit Basset Griffon Vendien, takes Best in Show in Crufts. It's the only award she's not won, and now she's bagged it for Gavin and Sarah Robertson.
Oh, what a moment. There's nothing to say other than congratulations, fantastic. And the Labrador
in reserve
Romeo
spot.
Romeo gets reserve Best in Show. But the glory goes to that magnificent Petit Basset Griffon Vendien.
In the Labrador Retriever, owners all over the country will be cheering for Romeo. Congratulations, just a very quick reaction from you.
Thank you very much. I'm sorry, my English is terrible. The better to speak my dog.
Romeo, what's your reaction? You are quite good, actually. Congratulations to both of you, particularly to our champion, our Best in Show, Gilly, the Petit Basset, and to Gavin. Well done. And the Labrador is quite a character as well, Romeo, and that's a good result in terms of international entries that have come here, a reserve place for the dog from Italy.
I think that's true. I thought also that it was a great spokesman for the breed, literally.
I love the fact he said, my English is not so good, you talk to my dog.
To my dog.
It has been a fabulous craft.